Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we're going to talk about fuel system stuff again. I know you guys are probably sick about it by now, but I just think this is something that I need to add. You know, I was talking on the forums and one of the guys was telling me that I was incorrect in how I characterized this plug on our fuel pump. This is what your fuel pump looks like on the B58. You can see it's all metal. It's a completely mechanical system. You have this one sensor on the end, but it doesn't actually control anything. And so I just kind of want to clarify how this works and, you know, kind of amend something that I said previously. So let's talk about it. So on our cars, we obviously have a lot of sensors, and a big one that people are concerned about are sensors related to our fuel pressure. Now this sensor right down here, this is the one that actually measures the pressure in your fuel rail. So you can see it plugs right into it. And you've got three injectors on this rail and three injectors on this rail in the back. And it basically measures the pressure that's going through your high pressure fuel system. Now, in order to modify that pressure, you need a fuel pressure regulator. And on older cars, the way that worked is you had basically a line that came off of your fuel rail and went back to your fuel tank. And the fuel pressure regulator would bleed off fuel that wasn't needed to help ensure that you were keeping your fuel pressure within the required range. Now on our cars, we have a returnless fuel system. So there's no extra fuel going back to the fuel tank, and the fuel pressure regulator is built into the fuel system itself. So where that is right here on your fuel pump. So what I said in a previous video is that this sensor is just monitoring fuel flow. And really it's not just monitoring fuel flow, it's controlling fuel flow. This sensor is actually controlling another piston inside of this fuel pump. And what it's doing is either constricting or freeing up the amount of fuel that can flow from the inlet to the outlet on the fuel pump. And that controls how much fuel is actually getting into the fuel rail. So it works in conjunction with this pressure sensor. When it sees that the pressure is getting too high, this sensor restricts how much fuel is going through the fuel pump to reduce the fuel pressure. And in the opposite way, if this sees pressure is too low, then this sensor will open up the fuel flow so that more fuel can get into the high pressure fuel system. So it works in conjunction with the pressure sensor. Now, what I was trying to address was that a lot of people thought this was the pressure sensor itself. So if they were having issues and seeing rail pressure drop, that something was wrong with the fuel pump, and that meant that the fuel pump failed. And in a way, that can be a part of the problem, but it's not typically true. So I was just trying to redirect you guys from focusing on this sensor itself. Now, another reason why this is important is because when you upgrade your fuel pump, sometimes you'll need to change the settings for the fuel pump. So when you're upgrading to a Dorch or a spool high pressure fuel pump, you'll need to check the box in your tune to make sure that it's calibrated appropriately for that pump. And what's actually being modified is the setting for that sensor on the pump itself. So on a spool pump and a Dorch pump, the way that sensor works and adjusts how much fuel is flowing through the fuel pump is different than how the OEM fuel pump works. And spool and Dorch both provide calibrations so that MHD and boot mode and MG flasher can adjust it in their off-the-shelf maps. It's also a setting that a custom tuner can adjust in their maps, but it's easier just to check the box in the configuration for the tune itself instead of trying to put it into the tune at your custom tuner. So that's what needs to be adjusted, and that's what you're adjusting when you go to that checkbox and pick Dorch Stage 1 or spool or whatever it is. you're changing how that sensor reads and the calibration that the car is using to adjust that piston in the fuel pump so that it can appropriately control your fuel pressure. A lot of times what people will experience is if they don't check that box, then the fuel pump will be really loud and it's chirping. And what you're hearing is basically the car trying to adapt and control the fuel pressure because the fuel pressure is getting so high. So if it's really, really loud, double check, make sure you check the setting in your tune so that it's calibrated for the fuel pump that you installed. So this is something that I think is a little less known on our cars. I have to give a big shout out to Marin over at Marin Tuned. He was the one that kind of walked me through this initially when I was trying to understand high pressure fuel pumps better and understand why certain fuel pumps needed settings to be adjusted compared to others. And he did a great job of explaining, you know, how it worked to me so that I could do a little more research and get a good understanding myself. But hopefully this helps you guys understand why certain fuel pumps need to have their settings updated and how a high pressure fuel pump works. This also explains why the TU pump doesn't need to be modified, because the way that the adjustment works matches the way that our OEM fuel pump works, so no settings needs to be changed there. Also, this doesn't change the fact that you can still rotate that connector if you do have a super fuel pump. Again, a lot of people have been running it without an issue. You just need to basically pop it off, rotate it, and then make sure it's pushed all the way back on before you reinstall. So hopefully this video helps. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Thanks. Doo 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 doo.